Wow, wasn't that bat cute? Now that we know a little bit more about pollinators, let's talk about how we can attract them to our backyards and our school gardens. We talked earlier about how important pollinators are to our food system. These pollinator gardens provide habitat to support and maintain pollinators by providing food in the form of pollen and nectar. This helps ensure that these important animals continue to keep pollinating our local crops and native plants. There are four main elements that you must have to make sure your pollinator garden can support your pollinators. The number one requirement is a food source like nectar and seeds. The second is a pooling area with shallow water. Next, you will need a place where pollinators can shelter themselves from predators in areas with shrubs and small trees. Lastly, your garden must have a lot of space for native plants to grow. Native means where something lives naturally. Your garden will attract native pollinators, so it's important that they have the native plants they are used to. If you plant plants native to the tropics, you will not attract pollinators in Georgia. It's also important to plant your garden facing north to south so it gets the most sunshine as it can. And don't forget to plant herbs too. Not only are they good in your food, but they also help keep the insects we don't want in our gardens away. Here are some other elements you might want to add to help attract even more pollinators to your garden. Hang a hummingbird feeder or two near your garden. Hummingbirds love the sweet, sugary taste and the red color of liquid hummingbird food. Make sure to hang up a birdhouse and a bird feeder as well, with lots of seeds to attract other types of birds. Put ripe fruit in a small basket and place or hang it in your garden. The strong smell of rotting fruit also attracts pollinators like butterflies. I mentioned earlier about having water elements in your garden. Butterflies love to puddle. Puddling is when butterflies land in an area with shallow water. They then suck up the liquid to get the nutrients they need to stay strong. Did you know that butterflies do not have a true mouth like a human does? Instead, they taste through their feet. Every time they land, they can taste what they're sitting on. Can you imagine that? You can make your own homemade pooling area for your butterflies by gluing small river rocks to the bottom of a flower pot tray and then filling it up with just a little bit of water. Not too much though, butterflies don't know how to swim. You can make your garden however big you want, but before you start to plant, it is important that you plan. Your pollinator garden must have a wide variety of plants that bloom throughout the spring, summer, and fall. That way you have pollinators almost all year round. It is also important to plant single bloom native flowers that have lots of nectar and are easy for pollinators to get to. A type of flower called an aster makes a great nectar source for pollinators. Some types of asters include daisies, coneflowers, and black-eyed Susans. Make sure to plant your flowers in similar color groups as well. Blues with blues and purples, reds with reds and oranges. We learned earlier that butterflies don't have the best sight. Planting in similar color groups makes it easier for them to see and land on the flowers. Don't just stop at flowers though. Herbs, small blooming shrubs, and even trees provide great resources for pollinators too. These types of plants often make great host plants for caterpillars and butterflies too. Did you know that caterpillars are particular about what they eat? Different species of butterflies only lay their eggs on certain types of plants. These plants are called host plants. On this slide, you can see the official state butterfly of Georgia, the eastern tiger swallowtail. This butterfly is found in large numbers because of its native host plants, including trees like the willow and birch tree, as well as the tulip poplar, which is blooming right now. Before you go out to buy your favorite host plant, make sure you think about a few things first. Many plants are treated with insecticides to keep the bad insects away, but those chemicals will also keep away the good insects like butterflies, bees, and beetles. Make sure you don't plant plants that have been treated with insecticides, and make sure you don't spray them on your garden either. One very special butterfly you'll want to plant for is the monarch butterfly. Monarchs are unique in that they are the only butterfly species to migrate. Monarchs live in various places around the world, but we get to see these very special butterflies up close and in person twice a year. Once in April and once in October, The butterflies fly right here through Georgia. These butterflies migrate and travel as their host plant, the milkweed, blooms. Milkweed plants are sometimes hard to find here in our area, especially the native kind. Most types of milkweed are fine, but one very colorful and very popular variety called Mexican milkweed can be dangerous. This type of plant is native to tropical regions like Mexico and the Caribbean. When planted here in Georgia, it blooms for an extra long time, which confuses the monarchs as they try to migrate. Make sure you look at the name tag on your milkweed before you buy it. All gardens have some insects that are not welcome and can even be harmful to your plants and animals. The traditional way of getting rid of these harmful insects is with a pesticide. As I mentioned before, though, these types of treatments do not know the difference between good bugs and bad bugs. There's a more natural alternative you can make right at home. Try out the recipe above and gently spray it on the leaves of your plants to help keep those bad bugs away, like aphids. This lesson should give you a good head start on your pollinator garden planning. However, there are other wonderful resources available, like these regional guides, that can give you even more information about pollinators, host plants, and pollinator needs. You can also research through the internet using good, reliable resources like universities and government agencies. A trip to the library to check out a book on pollinators is a great way to research as well. Hello again, boys and girls. Today was awesome. I enjoyed being here with you guys. Today we learned all about different kinds of pollinators, like the birds, bees, beetles, butterflies, and even bats. We also learned a lot about pollinator gardening and what elements you need in your garden to make sure that all those pollinators come. If you have any questions for Miss Kelly, please contact your teacher. She will let me know, and maybe I'll even do another video for you guys where I can answer some of your questions that you have about pollinators and pollinator gardening. I hope everyone has a wonderful week, and I hope to see you again soon.